the experience about the usage of EntOpenG based on open source software in order to try to help you or help your team to fix and to discover many, many problems about network. Okay, the agenda, introduction, motivation, use cases, some feature discussion or some feature think about new paradigm that could arrive and could face some enterprise customer. So it's right also to try to put EntOpenG in the future consideration. Something about me. I'm active on the IT security field since 2001. I'm quite about passionate about IT technology, IT security, as and especially in IT architecture. And probably I have much field experience on networking and application integration. And in the last years, also cloud. Okay, we could start with some bullet points that could try to understand the actual scenario that the customer is facing day by day, and also supplier like me, like my team, like you guys. Networks are growing at very fast rate in terms of number of endpoints, in terms of bandwidth, in terms of new connection in a new supplier. Networks are expanding because if you think in this day that we cannot do this meeting on-prem, but we need to do it remotely thanks to COVID, so networks are expanding. So many endpoints need to be managed and checked, but they are remotely than the end-top or than the core business. Smart working is growing, especially in the country that are not used to use it. And the business require that every day new service need to be delivered and need to be put on production. So the IT guys need to have a real a pane of glass in order to try to define and try to really understand what's going on their network. Sometimes for other part of the IT guys, the assurance teams or so on, compliance and so on, they need to be sure that the network team or the security team apply the security policy or they do job in due diligence, due care and due diligence. So many tools need to be implemented and many panel need to be aggregated. So probably one of the big thing is that. So EntOp try to help you and obviously will help you. Also cybersecurity now that is very cold in calling action about the latest events called supply chain or so on. So every day you need to improve your visibility on the network flow, on the network application, the network endpoint. And at the end, I put cybersecurity paradigm to approach because if you think on the same network like the network guys, you need to think also on the for the cybersecurity point of view. And the cybersecurity is starting to moving to the zero trust approach. So, what could do EntOpenG with zero trust? Okay. Let's start with some use case, but before I try to do a small introduction that every day the IT guys or the customer support has. So the typical customer supplier conversation it's something like that, that the customer probably has some problem, but has no metrics to share with the IT guys, the IT support guys. So the only thing is that something probably is not working as expected. Okay, what tool could help you in some small step in order to start to reduce the issue surface or the attack surface? And top, I will start with the first case. First case, officially, was based on some problem about some download fails. And I put the packet evidence because there was too many keep alive in the conversation between the endpoint station and the public web service. And probably the user doesn't know nothing about what technology are in the path between him and the web service. At the end, we discovered that there was a security service that was put in the way without declaring it on the IT policy. So practically man in the middle. And we detected it thanks to the end-top alert log output. Why log output? Because for the endpoint station point of view, the download is still alive. But at the end of the some time out, the download failed. So the user obviously every time called the IT support asking them and to try to fix. But also the support guys didn't know nothing about what the network manager did on the firewall point of view. So we discovered that a misconfiguration, probably officially a misconfiguration, but there was some introduction about HTTPS encryption. So first of all, technically it was a download phase problem and some internet problem about some on website, okay? But technically it was introduced man in the middle. So it's not correct because no one advised the customer, no one advised that there was HTTPS. So also in the documentation part of the cybersecurity, no one advised. So probably a type of security incident, not more targeted to the network. Okay, but thanks to NetTop, we discovered this man in the middle, and so we fix it. Another case was how can a company can verify if all the team, network team, security team, compliance team are working in the right way, or better, in the same way. Yeah, the only method is try to verify the security effectiveness of the solution. That too many times the IT guys has less time, so they introduce the technology, they introduce the new access control, but they haven't the right time to try or to matrix the effectiveness. So in that case, one of the main protection technology adapted to this customer, it was to adopt some GOP filtering on the perimeter. And what's the real problem in that case? What was the real problem? That on the perimeter, the restriction specify that also the Russian country needed to be blocked, but on top that is on the internal network and show that that GOP filtering was not implemented on the best way. Why? Because on the flow that the NTOP show in the GUI and also in the alarm that the network guys received in their WOSA, country blacklisted, flow is already up and running. So another time, NTOP it was used to manage the effectiveness of the security. Also, if NTOP is public known, like a flow visibility or network flow monitoring, but it depends of the view that you apply on that flow. Another case. This is a very good case that Microsoft release a central ATP, a cloud CM located in the Azure, and the customer need to improve the visibility of their branch, the network visibility of the branch in the CM, in order to create or to better correlate the rule, in order to trigger some alert, or to start to see that something is not going in the right way. So technically, what we do, we implemented NTOP Enterprise, and we added also some mprobe, so flow exporting visibility, and we defined the right alarm and the right trigger in order to have the final goal, that is a CM correlation in Sentinel that we need to ask and to trigger the alert and warning the right team, network team, enterprise network, or security or application. So this was a good, very, very, very good things about use of NTOP. In that days, because this case was related about October, in our October situation, last week this case was very, very disincremented because we saw that starting from Nigeria, there was too many attacks in other branches of that customer. Another thing, it was to increase the blacklist country and increase the CM CM correlation, and we fixed a wrong flow that starting from the inside and go in Nigerian country. Okay, another good things. I put for you technical guys a log. So what Sentinel saw in that case about the alert that NTOP generated. So very, very good combination and very good correlation that could do in that case. But Sentinel is not one of the CM that you can use to enlarge your visibility or to increase the correlation. Also other tool is on the way, for example, Elastic or so on. Another good case, another border case about security and the network availability. In that case, is a wireless ISP that from the ISP point of view, there was some lack or some networking problem. And one of his customer is suffering slow bandwidth. So if you analyze the end user CPE monitoring from the wireless control room, okay, the bandwidth it's about 21 megabyte, and there is some packet loss, but probably it could be generated from the internal network of the customer. But at the end, when we try to discover and to fix the when we try to find the real root causes, root cause, sorry, for the problem, we discover that the customer is already suffering from many, many connections starting to blacklisted country. Okay, this is a typical case that this data, or sorry, this incident, you need to apply it on the network or in the cybersecurity side, probably both. But another time, thanks to a single tool that could allow you to jump from the network one or the security field, you can start to fix in really, really small time. And you can really understand what's happening and what's going on. I put another case that is more frequently on the enterprise customer, that it's something about configuration baseline or policy appliance, because sorry policy application, because sometimes the customer asking or open ticket about that there is some bandwidth problem or some security service or some delivery service that is not work properly, especially when you have an enterprise worldwide span. So you need to keep an eye, and probably when you have at this type of customer, one of the main thing is try to verify the effectiveness, not also of the security, but also of the policy on the networking service and the networking infrastructure service, like a DNS, the actual case. And thanks to one of the latest NTOP alert, NTOP NG alert that was introduced, the unexpected DNS or SMTP or NTP or DHCP settings, where NTOP could trigger or could help you alerting you. Okay, in that case, it was unexpected DNS server. So starting from the internal IT, something probably starting to work not in the expected way, but when we put an eye on the networking behavior on the remote point, we discover that there was something wrong, or someone didn't do their job, because like you said, sorry, like you can see on the slide, there was a DNS that was unexpected, that the one that that was configured to really answer to the to real things. Okay, what's the future? What's the future? Probably, if you are really interested in to put some new idea or to try to migrate your customer or try to migrate your knowledge about networks and network conversation, or you want to mitigate some networking problem but also security one, the only one new paradigm that could allow you and to help you to create the new paradigm without or lowering the surface, the attack surface or the problem surface, is to introduce the zero trust networking architecture. Yeah, zero trust, what in some small words, zero trust is a new paradigm based on a simple idea that you could see only what you are authorized to. The actual solution, the actual security architecture, or the actual security paradigm, block a request when the request arrives to the endpoint. So if you need to have access to the web server, is the web server that allow you or block your request. So zero trust, it is the opposite. You could see the web server if you are authorized to do it. So your request will be blocked at the start, not at the end. So if you imagine a zero trust approach in the actual situation or in the actual security landscape, many attacks could be blocked at the origin because there was no authentication or there was no right to have the potential impact on the network, because the network service or the application service was not allowed to go and to speak with other, because zero trust in the best way allow you to close all the environment in a single enclave. So web service, okay, a single enclave, DNS server, a single enclave. You are on the network, okay, if you are authorized and you are identified and you are meeting all the requirements, for example, the work days, working hour, and all the other things, or you are authorized to see the final resources, okay? So in that paradigm, NTOP could help us, yeah, because zero trust, in order to work correctly, need to have the first thing that is identification, but there is access gateway and access controller, then zero trust access controller and zero trust access gateway that need to speak both and continuously, because they need to verify if your connection is authorized, it's real and it's trusted every time during your session. So another way, how can you verify if that session is already doing the expected behavior? Another time, you need to use a technology that allow you to see the stream, to see the flows, and to verify the flows is arriving from the endpoint that that was authorized to do. Okay, probably one of the main issue that the NTOP will be calling action to fix is to monitor the zero trust paradigm, and probably is already ready, but doing and implement the zero trust in the best way is not only a visibility problem, but is something that need to be thought at the architecture level. But keep in mind that NTOP, like the actual days, in the whole days, but in the next day, could help you to real understand what you need to migrate from the actual architecture in zero trust. And if you can, and if you are happy to start from scratch with that zero trust paradigm, okay, you need to have the right tool in order to see what's going on also in the test environment. Because sometimes when you approach the zero trust problem, is to really verify the effectiveness of the zero trust paradigm. Because zero trust is not only put some technology in some DNZ and so on. No, it's not that. It's more global architectural idea that need to embrace all the actual technology that are working on the network. And with a tool like NTOP, you could better create your plan to migrate the actual enterprise infrastructure to the new one. Keep in mind that in the actual paradigm, you are allowed to see resources, okay, and only on the access phase, your access is confirmed. During a zero trust section, you are under constant verification, under constant assurance. So if you do something wrong in the session, your session will be killed. So if you think that the IT guys IT support guys, security guys, network guys of a company that need to approach zero trust need to add the real instrument that allow you to justify and also to do a statistics and also to have a matrix about the behavior of the zero trust. So like I told you before, probably NTOP is already ready, but the problem is not if it's not related to NTOP capabilities, but is related to the architectural view that you want to then to what to approach. Keep in mind that security is already a day by day technology and a day by day path that you need to achieve. So another time, you need to do assurance, and you need to verify if all the security and the networking strategy you put in place are effective. In conclusion, this is a good slide that I use sometimes, but NTOP is a tool that allow you to see the same data from a different point of view. For example, architectural view, if you have an architect or solution architect, from the networking view, if you are a networking guys, because you can see packet quality, you can measure the out of order, you can have a bunch of metrics that you can use to improve your technology. Or if you are a security field engineer, not a problem, because there is many things that you can use. For example, flow score, blacklisted, or some type of attack that you could to start to mitigate, or some anomaly based. So there is also for the security passionate guys, there is also an integration with the Suricata engine. So why not use it? Why not implement, or why not increase your visibility from the security point of view with the single tool? This could help you on a day-by-day basis.